driveway is dim and pour a butter rim. Get the back in at the door and let the dogs kill. Point them out, then turn around, that's how we let them in. Paying no one conversation, then I switch to sim. Little like NBA business, I ain't talking scrimmage. You know I'm James Bond with it, Harden with the finish. Your whips got curtain options in it, I don't need a tenant. Just need the option not to see them when I'm riding in it. Used to spend checks on my Nikes, now they pay me.
What's up, it's Will from Kicks on Court. Today we have a review of the Nike PG2.
Say you won't smoke, come get it. Come on, you wanna play dumb, I'm with it. I'm about to take over the city. I came with my committee, gang with it. Came for the bag and the profit.
Nike PG3 is Paul George's third signature shoe with Nike, and this colorway is the Black History Month colorway.
Starting off with traction.
The tractions on these shoes started off very poor. The first few times I wore them, I was sliding around everywhere, but as I broke them in, really starting to improve, and now I barely need to wipe these things. The circular pattern on the bottom barely picks up any dust and is super reliable. Here I have a translucent colorway, and as you can see, the bottom picks up a lot of dust, so I'd recommend buying the rubber outsole. Because the traction took some time to break in, I initially thought I wasted $110 on these shoes. Luckily, I was wrong.
Moving on to cushion.
The cushion setup is basically the same as the PG1 and the PG2, where it's zoom in the forefoot and then just normal cushion in the rest of the shoe. However, once broken in, it did feel smoother. As in the other shoes, you would feel the zoom and different from the cushion, but this, it just feels like one fluid ride. The midsole in this is actually lighter and softer than any of the other Paul George shoes, and I think that contributes to the smoothness.
Moving on to materials.
The upper materials could be better. It's just cheap synthetic and bad mesh. It's a little stiff at first. However, on foot, though, it doesn't really feel very bad at all.
Finishing up here with support.
Heel. For support, there's an internal heel counter. This helps keep your foot inside of the shoe and not shaking around or anything while inside. There's an outrigger to stop your foot from going over this way so you can't twist your ankle like that. These wings on the side, when you tie them, they hold your foot in place so that you don't slide laterally. For me, it worked very well because the shoe is pretty thin and it's not too wide, so I'm a thin footer, but maybe for a wide footer, I would say go up half a size. So for the final verdict, I actually hated these shoes the first few times I played in them. Thought that they were so bad and they were just such a letdown after the other Paul Georges were very good shoes. However, as I kept breaking them in, I quickly discovered that these were actually probably my favorite basketball shoe ever. I love playing in them. These and the Kobe 8s, which there will be a review of the Kobe 8s coming out in a few days. These and the Kobe 8s are the best freaking basketball shoes I've ever laced on my feet. If I was gonna recommend buying one pair of basketball shoes, it would be the PG3s, just because they're so cheap and they're just amazing performers. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like, comment, rate, share, and subscribe. As I said, I'll have a Kobe 8 video up soon, and I just did a review on the LeBron Soldier 10s if you want to check those out. Peace.
And she don't really care because everybody want the same thing. New chain, new car, and the same ring. I just wanna make money with the same gang. New glass, new frame, but the same lane. Whole team code different, but the same pain. Really, I just wanna play.